हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ शिप्रा हाड़ा फ्रॉम शिव ज्योति एजुकेशनल ग्रुप कोटा। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 7, दैट इज फ्रैक्शंस। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल सी व्हाट आर द फ्रैक्शंस, हाउ कैन वी रीड अ फ्रैक्शन एंड हाउ कैन वी राइट अ फ्रैक्शन। सो नाउ टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस टॉपिक, टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस चैप्टर, वी हैव टू यूज दीज टू चॉकलेट्स। व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू यूज टुडे, वी विल यूज दीज चॉकलेट्स। So it's going to be very interesting. So just look here. First of all, I'm going to tell you what are the fractions. So students, open page number 95 in your book. Open page number 95. So now what are the fractions? When a thing is divided into equal parts. What did I say? When a thing is divided into equal parts, these parts are known as fraction. Is it clear? When we are having collection of something, when we have a whole thing and we are dividing it into equal parts, hum isko kya kar rahe hain, equal parts mein divide kar rahe hain, then it will be a fraction. So now how can we read a fraction and how can we write a fraction? We can write a fraction like number of selected parts divided by number of selected parts divided by, or you can say upon, total number of equal parts. So now I am just going to open it. How can we show a fraction, how can we read a fraction and how can we write a fraction? So now just look at these blocks of this chocolate, the pieces of this chocolate. How many pieces we can see here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So how many total number of pieces we can see? We can see 10 pieces. So total to kya ho gaya chocolate ka? 10 pieces. Is it clear? Don't forget it. We have 10 pieces of this chocolate. Now what I am going to do? I am going to eat 4 pieces of this chocolate. Main kya karne wali hu? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 pieces of chocolate I am going to eat now. So now I have eaten 4 pieces of this chocolate. Now how many pieces are remaining here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Suppose the question is, what is the fraction of pieces eaten by me? Jo pieces maine kha liye, uska fraction kya hai? So now the fraction is number of selected parts. And what is the question? The pieces what I have eaten, jo maine kaha liye. So how many pieces I have eaten? 4 pieces. 4 pieces I have eaten. And now total number of equal parts. And what the total parts? I have shown you the total pieces 10. 10 pieces the humare paas starting mein. And I have eaten 4 pieces. So what is the fraction? The fraction is 4 upon 10. Ye kiska fraction hai? Chocolate. Pieces of chocolate eaten by me, the fraction will be 4 upon 10. Now what I am going to do? Now I am going to take 2 more pieces. So now what is the fraction? I have eaten 6 pieces. Maine 6 pieces kha liye. So now the fraction will be 6 upon 10. Question is, what is the fraction pieces of chocolate eaten by me? So the fraction will be 6 upon 10. Is it clear? Now suppose the question is, what is the fraction of remaining pieces? Jo pieces baj gaye. So how many remaining pieces are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 4 remaining pieces. And the question is, tell me the fraction of the remaining pieces of chocolate. So the now the fraction is, now the remaining part is 1, 2, 3, 4. So remaining part will come here and upon always will be whole number. It means the total number of pieces, that is 10. Is it clear, students? And the fraction is 2 upon 5. Is it clear? So this is a dividing line and we have a number top at the top and at the bottom. Is line ke upar ek number hai aur is line ke niche ek number hai. So what is this number? This number is 2 and this number will be numerator. This number is called numerator, which is coming above this line. Is line ke upar jo number aa raha hai, that will be numerator. Is it clear? Aur line ke niche jo number hai, that will be denominator. Line ke upar wala number, that will be numerator, and this number will be denominator. And this is called a fraction. This is called a fraction. Is it clear, students? Now we can read it like 2. And this number will be 5th. F-I-F-T-H-S. What you have to do? You have to use T-H-S in denominator. How can we read this number? We can read this number, we can write this number like 2/5. Is it clear? We are taking one more. 1 upon 4. This is 1 upon 4. Is it clear? And we can write it like 1/4. Is it clear? Now we will not use S. Why we are not using S? Because in numerator we have 1. Numerator mein kya hai? Humare paas 1. So whenever you are having 1 in numerator, you will not write S here. Aapko yahan S nahi likhna hai. Is it clear, students? So now this number will be numerator, this is denominator, and we have to use this number 2 upon 4, 2 upon 5, and this will be fraction. Is it clear? So now, students, open page number 96, exercise 7.1. Exercise 7.1, page number 96. And now we will take question number 1. So now, question number 1 is of exercise 7.1, question 1. Write W for whole and F for fraction in the boxes. So we can see some parts here, A, B, C, D and E, F part here we can see. So first of all, we are observing A part. As you can see, students, this is a whole and we are separating one thing. Hum ek part ko kya kar rahe hain? Separate kar rahe hain. So this will be a fraction. Is it clear? Because we are dividing, we are separating one part from this whole part. Is it clear? So this will be a fraction. Now look at the B part. Can you see any dividing part, any separating part here? No, we are not able to see any separating part here. So this is a whole and we have to write W. Now look at the C part. Again, we are not able to see any separating part, any dividing part here. So this will be a whole. Then again D part. We can see an apple is divided into two pieces. Two parts mein humne kya kiya hai? Apple ko divide kiya hai. So this will be a fraction. So we have to write F here. Is it clear? Now again E part, we are not dividing it in equal parts. So this will be whole part and this will be W. We have to use W here. As we can see, F part, we are separating one piece and this will be fraction. So now we will see the next question, question number 2. This is copy work. Question number 2 is, represent the following fractions in numbers. Represent the following fractions in numbers. Question number 2. And A part is 1/3. So students, question is 1/3. As I have told you, the first word which we are using, it will be numerator, and the numerator will come above the dividing line and this will be 1, 1. Is it clear? Then third, it will be denominator and we have to write denominator here. And this will be a fraction 1/3. Is it clear? We are taking one more part of this question, B part we are taking. And the B part is 3/8. So now, what is the numerator here? Numerator is 3, so we will write 3 here. And then 8, so we will write 8 here. In this way, you can convert this these in fractions. Is it clear? Now we will see the next question. Question number 3. Iska just opposite question hai. Question 3. In question number 3, we are having some fractions and we have to convert these fractions in words. Hame usse words mein likhna hai. So A part is 1/6. So how can we write this 1/6 in words? Kaise likh sakte hain hum isko word mein? First we have to write numerator, that is 1, then 6. So kaise maine aapko 6 likhna bataya? You have to write 6 THS. What you have to use? You have to use THS. And this will be 6. So now students, as I have told you, in numerator, whenever you are having 1, jab bhi numerator mein 1 hai, we will not use S. Is it clear? Now we are taking one more, B part. And the B part is 2/5. So now, how can we write this in words? First, we will write 2. That is numerator, then we have to write 5. Kaise likhoge 5 ko? It will be 5th. THS. Is it clear? So in this way you can convert fractions to words. Now we are moving to the next question. Question number 4 on page number 97. And question number 4 is, write the numerator and denominator of the following fractions. Question, in this question we have to write numerator and denominator. Very simple question students, we can see some fractions here and as I have told you, jo bhi number upar likha hua hai, that will be numerator aur niche wala number kya ho jayega? Denominator, very simple. So now here you can see numerator is 3, so you have to write 3 here. And denominator is 5, so you have to write 5 here, simple. Now in B part, we have 4/7. So, upar wala number kaun sa hai? We can see 4, so numerator will be 4. And what is the denominator? We can see denominator is 7. Is it clear? Now you can do C, D and E part also. So, just look at this question, question number 5. Question number 5 is, look at the figures and write the fraction represented by the shaded portion. Also write the numerator and denominator of the fraction. So students, we have to find the fraction of shaded area. Hum shaded area dekh sakte hain, shaded part. So how can you write a fraction? What did I teach you? Kaise likhna hai aapko fraction? First you have to see the total number of parts. Total parts kitne hai? So now we are counting the total parts 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many total parts are here? Total parts are 8. And this will come in denominator. So humne denominator kya likh diya? 8. Now we have to count the shaded parts, jo parts shaded hain. So we can see 1, 2, 3. 3 parts are shaded here. So the numerator will be 3. So now what is the numerator? Numerator is 3, jo upar aa raha hai, and the denominator is 8. Is it clear? So now the B part is, again we have to count the total number of parts and that will come as a denominator. So now 1, 2, 3, 4. How many total parts are here? Total parts 4. Is it clear? Now let me count the shaded part. As we can see, there is one part which is shaded and we have to write 1 in numerator. So now again numerator is 1 and denominator is 4. Is it clear, students? Now you can see. Now you can do C, D, E, F part also. Now we are coming to the next exercise, that is exercise 7.2. Before starting this exercise, open page number 97. Now we are going to see some common fractions. अभी हम क्या देखेंगे? Some common fractions. Now what are the some common fractions? So here, students, just look at this circle. As you can see, this is a whole part. Whole part means complete. Complete part है ये. Now what I am going to do? I am dividing this whole part into two equal parts. मैंने क्या किया? इस whole part को two equal parts में divide कर दिया. Now the each fraction, each part will be 1 upon 2. Why 1 upon 2? Because I am dividing the whole part into two equal parts. मैंने two equal parts में divide किया है. So the each part will be 1 upon 2, or we can say half. What we can say? We can say half. 1 upon 2, or we can say it half. Is it clear, students? So now, suppose I am dividing the same circle in 3 equal parts. अब मैं क्या कर रही हूँ? Same circle को I am dividing it into 3 equal parts. मैंने इसको 3 equal parts में divide किया. 1, 2, 3. You can see 3 equal parts here. मैंने इसको 3 equal parts में divide कर दिया. So now I am dividing the circle into 3 equal parts. 3 parts में divide कर रही हूँ. So each piece will be 1 upon 3. Why 1 upon 3? Because we are dividing it into 3 equal parts. So this will be 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 3. Is it clear? Now suppose I am dividing this circle, the same circle, into 4 equal parts. मैं इसको किस में divide कर दूँ? 4 equal parts में divide कर दूँ. 1, 2, 3, 4. So each piece will be, each piece is known as 1 upon 4. Is it clear? कैसे read करूंगी मैं इसे? 1 upon 4. Is it clear, students? So these are some common fractions. So now we will see exercise 7.2, question number 1. Exercise 7.2 is question number 1. Match the following columns. Now column A and column B, two columns are given in the question. And the A part, you can see 2 upon 5. So how can you write 2 upon 5 in words? कैसे लिखेंगे हम 2 upon 5 को words में? First we will write 2, then 5 को क्या लिखेंगे? Fifths. You can see 2 fifths? Yes, we can see here. So the answer is 2 fifths. So I have written A here. This is the answer of A part. Is it clear? Now the B part is 3 upon 4. How can we write this 3 upon 4 in words? We will write 3 fourths. So we can see this, 3 fourths. So what is the answer of B part? The answer of B part is 4. So I have written B here. Is it clear? Now 1 upon 2. Just I have told you 1 upon 2 is known as half. 1 upon 2 kya hota hai? Half hota hai. So you can see the first answer. So I have written C here. So now the last is 4 upon 7. We can write it like 4, 7. This is the answer of D. So I have written D here. Is it clear? So now we will see the next question, question number 2. And question number 2 is, write the fraction for the shaded parts of each figure. Again, we are going to write a fraction. Fraction, jab bhi hum likhenge, first of all, we have to see the total number of parts. So now in A part, how many total parts are here? 1, 2, 3, 4. We can see 4 parts. So total parts we will write as a denominator. So I have written 4 here. Now we have to find the fraction of shaded parts. Hume shaded parts ka fraction find karna hai. So let me count the shaded parts. 1, 2. There are 2 blocks. We can see 2 parts are shaded. So numerator will be 2. And this is the fraction of shaded parts. Is it clear? Now just look at the B part. First of all, to write this as a fraction, we have to count the total number of parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many total parts are here? Total parts 5. And now let me count the shaded parts 1, 2, 3. Ab shaded part kahan aa jayega? As a numerator. And the fraction will be 3 upon 5. Now you can do C, D, E and F part also. Now we will move to the next question. So now question number 3 is color the figures to show the given fractions. So now we can see some fractions are given here and we have to show these fractions by using the colors. We have to color the boxes. So as we can see 3 upon 4, it means what this 4 is showing? The total number of parts, because 4 is coming as a denominator. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, total parts 4, and we have to color 3 parts because numerator is 3. So now what I am going to do, I am going to color 3 parts. So this is the first part and this is the next part I have colored and this is the third part. So here I have colored 3 parts and the fraction will be 3 upon 4. Is it clear? Now the B part is 5 upon 8. 5 upon 8. It means total number of parts 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we have to color 5 parts. Hame kitne parts color karne? 5 parts. Why? Because numerator is 5. So now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I have colored 5 parts. Now we will do the same in this question also. 5 total parts and we have to color 2 parts. So 1, 2. Is it clear? Now you can do D, E, F and all the parts you can do now. Now we will move to the next question. And the next question is question number 4. And question number 4 is color one part of each figure, red, blue, orange, to show 1 upon 2, 1 upon 3, 1 upon 4 respectively. So students, whenever we are going to show 1 upon 2, we have to use red color. To show 1 upon 3, we have to use blue color. And to show 1 upon 4, we will use orange color. So as you can see, A part, in A part, we are observing the picture. We can see how many total number of parts are here. The total parts are 2. So it means we have to show the fraction as 1 upon 2. It means we have to use red color. So now one part you can see I have colored it red. Now the B part you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Total number of parts 4. It means the fraction will be 1 upon 4. So I have to use orange color. So now I have colored it as orange. So now the C part is 1, 2, 3. Total number of parts are 3. It means I have to use for 1 upon 3. Kya use karna hai mujhe 1 upon 3 ke liye? I have to use blue color. So I have colored it. I have colored this picture like blue color. Maine isko blue color se kya kar diya? Color kar diya. So now the next question is question number 5. Write fractions for the parts shaded dark and light. So now again we have to see the whole parts 1, 2, 3. So how many total number of parts are here? 3. So 3 I have written here also and here also. So now numerator for dark. Jab hum dark ki baat kar rahe, it means we have to see the dark part. Kaun sa dark shaded hai? We can see only one part is here. So for dark part the fraction will be 1 upon 3. And now we have to see the light parts 1, 2. How many total parts we can see? 2 parts. So the fraction will be 2 upon 3. Now you can do this question also. Total number of parts we can see 16. And dark part we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So for dark parts fraction will be 6 upon 16. And the remaining parts will be light. And the fraction will be 10 upon 16. Is it clear, students? So now rest of the parts you can do yourself. I hope you understood this part well. In the next part of this video, we will do exercise 7.3, 7.4 and 7.5. I hope you understood it well.